side.
They're taking the hobbits to Isengard.
A diversion.
We went into the orchard itself, as far away from any official staff people, and proceeded to hurl apples at each other and into the sky and wherever we wanted to.
Becca's window is just gone.
Oh, Becca's window.
Her new
gone.
Car.
Wait, are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah. You guys, I'm going to send one of the videos that we took to the National Weather Channel. See if we'll get it on TV.
Wow, that's a school, yeah? I think,
yeah. Hey!
Oh,
hey.
It started.
Well
done.
This is a good sword.
John Mather with a capital J.
What?
I like to go outside in the snow to play.
Hey.
I am a Calvinist.
Don't
come to me and shake your fist. I'll
Should
tell you that theology.
Word?
I'll tell you all of what you need to know. Cause I don't go blow. Cocaine, cause I keep it clean. I'm bald like Mr. Clean. What? What?
All you gotta say, Caleb
hey,
D.
Hey,
here we go.
Hey.
Oh, ow, 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 ow.
No, I'm sleeping, right? Everyone's
sleeping.
Nine to seven. Working 2 extra hours so I can bring home that extra melon. Got an apartment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Close. You like a
favorite memory would have to be the first year I lived here. We had a Christmas party. And the Christmas party was just awesome. It started out, well, first it was snowing, like a foot. And everybody showed up with some great sweaters. We had a reenaction of the nativity scene. Quinn was baby Jesus, so that was always fun. And then we went to some decorating cookies, which everyone participated. It got really competitive. I think I got gypped out of not winning. What's new? It's probably a NATO or something like that. I don't know. But then we all went out and had a snowball fight. And it was the most epic snowball fight there was. We had a big mound of snow that we played King of the Hill on, and it was just great. And then, you know, we all came back in, we made some hot cocoa and watched The Grinch. That was a great memory, just everybody participating in. Yeah, it was a really fun time.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Jason!
Oh,
gosh. Happy birthday to you!
That was perfect. Yes. That was beautifully in tune, you guys.
Mike and Mike clapping.
I don't know, man.
I think it was a bird.
You know, Jason always just talks about his Idaho chips, and it's just hilarious because he talks about it all the time.
You know what I really don't understand, though, is how Jason's always talking about these stupid Idaho chips. I don't understand what's so special about them at all.
Oh, hey, Caleb, you talking about those Tim's Cascade jalapeno-style chips?
My favorite moment at KPA is probably pretty recent. We were walking back from going out for drinks for my birthday party, and we hadn't had that many drinks. We'd only had a few each or one or two, but for some reason everyone was just in the perfect mood. We walked back from West Bank, and the entire time we just sang songs super loudly. Like, we just made up tons of songs and sang them, and they were so bad, but they were amazing, and I'm sure it was just awesome to hear that from whoever it was. I'm sure Minneapolis is in our debt for how loud and amazing we sang that night. Oh, that was good. That was a good birthday.
And she don't know what to do. She lost her shoe on the sidewalk on the way home. She lost her shoe and she don't know the way home. She lost her shoe on the sidewalk on the way home. She lost her shoe and she don't know what to do. She lost her shoe. Shoe. She lost her shoe. Shoe.
Really, guys?
She lost her shoe.
She lost her shoe.
Lost her shoe. She lost her shoe.
She lost her shoe.
I want to leave, Mama. I don't want to leave.
Remember that part?
Where's that from?
I don't think that's
Two Towers. Yeah. Two Towers, she puts them on the horse.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Ride with your sister.
I'm so mad.
Wait, let me stick my arm out there. Push it open.
Push it open. Go, pull it.
No,
Quinn, not all the way. I just want to see what it's like out there.
Oh my god. Quinn, no. Careful, you stupid. Okay, watch out.
and then the hug, and then the next line. It's wonderful to see
you. Should have thrown yourself.
No! So, definitely gonna miss Amado cooking fish all the time, just stinking up that hallway. Oh my goodness, you could smell it from 2 miles away. I'm gonna miss the raw chicken giblets that she just leaves out on the counter as if nothing can grow on them. I know, Amado. I know. Oh. Gonna miss the guy's bathroom and the nice layer of hair that we get on the counter like every Monday night before somebody cleans it for chores. That one I'm gonna miss. Coming down the hallway and just like unexpectedly walking into a WWE match that all the guys are having on the floor. That one, that'll definitely miss as well. Yeah. That's it.
Oh, Lord.
What is that? It's from Glory.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Lord.
Right before they go into battle.
Oh, Lord.
You know this one?
Oh, Lord.
Guys, it was literally like 2 blocks
away. That feels so weird! Oh my gosh! I don't know, but it's like... It's like rocks, but it's really, really cool! Wow!
I'm sorry, huh?
Got an A in English muffins.
Son, now there's a time to speak. There's a time to be silent. We do not let the woman speak.
Second Timothy, it's in there.
It's in the New Testament. Go read it for yourself.
I lost it.
Don't. At dawn, look to the east.
Listen, I really appreciate your help with trying to answer these questions. Like, your advice is really great. It's like, but it's boring. I'm not being sarcastic right now. I'm not good at being sarcastic, I guess. I'm just discovering this at this very moment. But your advice is really bad. I should have said it's really good if I wanted to be sarcastic, but I'm not being sarcastic. It's bad. Oh. Listen, you're doing it right now. You're motioning with your mouth. You're trying to get me to say things. It's bad. It's bad. You need, yeah.
I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand.
We all
need somebody to lean on. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on strong. It won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
What, another?
Wait,
say about this, tomato.
I've seen it in Kansas before.
You've never seen anything
have,
like
but
this.
But not this bad.
Oh my gosh.
Tomato, can you do an African dance to commemorate this?
Oh my gosh, please. No, we need that in the
hail. I'll do it with you.
Okay. In the hail.
We celebrate the snow in French.
Secret? Is it safe?
We got our special guest up here, who a lot of us have been waiting for, Mr. John Buettner.
Mr. John Buettner.
We also have another pastor in the house. I hear John Madden, why don't you come up here?
John Madden, why don't you just come up?
I've said my piece.
John Madden, a great friend of our church.
He's a great friend.
Of course, a longtime supporter of First Covenant Baptist.
First Covenant Baptist.
Amen.
Covenant.
First Covenant Baptist. I remember a couple Junes ago, we went to Noah's Ark.
Noah's Ark Water Park.
Down in the Dells. Yeah. Up in the Dells. Up in the Dells. And,
what's up?
I was so fat I couldn't fit down the slide.
Get all the barbecues in here. Yeah. But I do remember something. Mr. John Madden was there. The pastor John Madden. You all know him, John Madden. He has the church over on Oak
Second
Street.
Second Covenant Baptist.
Second Coming Baptist.
And I do remember he said, what did he say, Pastor Dom?
You can't start off.
Well, Pastor Dom was there. I wasn't. He told me the story.
No, I wasn't there. I really wasn't there.
Lisa, I'm sorry. I do not remember the story, but it was great. It was something about faith that we need to have for that going down the slide of life.
Jesus says, if you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can tell that mountain to go fall like it'll go fall like. Do we have that faith?
Right.
That's what we gotta ask ourselves, ladies and gentlemen. We should just preach sometimes.
For real.
Team preach.
I believe Elder Quinn has a word for us today.
Elder Quinn. Father Quinn Christmas.
We decided to give him 10 minutes before the worship to speak, so Elder Quinn, this is your time.
Please take the full amount
Elder
of time.
Will come up and,
take all 10
do
minutes.
Do today's readings. Today's readings
Elder
from
Quinn,
Songs of Songs.
17.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Jesus said, let my people pray.
Amen.
Let my people pray.
Woo! Pray to the gazelles.
Wait, what?
We have
Songs of Songs.
To the Songs of Songs.
Pray to the gazelles.
Songs of Songs.
Songs.
And what was that other word you were sharing with me earlier, Quinn? What was the other thing you were going to say?
I feel like I'm getting a message. A message from on high.
Amen.
From our Lord.
On high.
I feel like we need Jason Tower.
Oh.
Has something
Jason
to say.
Tower,
the Lord has called you.
Bring wood and oil.
I got buck teeth. They're not buck, they're like fangs, but they're walrus fangs. And they match my bangs. Dye my hair white to match my teeth. Sometimes I'll get them plated gold. removable walrus.
Tell me, friend.
When did Saruman the Wise abandon reason for madness?
I feel so helpless.
This is what sin is like. You can't save yourself.
Sick.
Again.
No. Well, I don't really know what it's going to be like to live in KPA because I've only been here for 2 days.
So what I really love about KPA is just the sense of community and just for us to really be there for one another and just to encourage one another and come around one another in times where we need prayer or whatever it may be. Yeah, I just love the genuineness that people have here too, and just, yeah, the ability to live with one another and even the challenges that present itself, because it's not easy to live in community sometimes. And so we continually are being changed and transformed into something beautiful, and just, yeah, it's really cool to be able to be a part of this and yeah, just have that community to go to, and it's like a family, so it's like, it's really cool to have that.
I mean... Give me a second. No, I'm gonna miss it here. See? Not when I try, it feels like I'm trying. Okay.
My favorite moment at KPA? Well, the whole thing was like a moment. Like, not to be weird. Just getting to know people and then just understanding their humor and their character has been a lot of fun. And my favorite times have been with John Matta and Ryan Lucas. Just D'ing around and making extremely bigoted statements just for fun. But then like feeling bad about it and then like talking through those things. Like, that's been great. I really love that we just constantly go to CBS home. That's fun too. So what I love about KPA, my favorite moments about KPA, the whole thing, man. The whole thing. Some people live a lifetime for a moment like this.
I mean, I'm gonna miss drawing on the whiteboards, and I'm gonna miss blockading the door on the girls' floor, and things like that.
What I'm gonna miss at the KPA, besides, you know, Jason always talking about his chips, which he says are the best.
Okay, Jason.
And besides, you know, Amado not showing me the love that I deserve. On a serious note, I'm gonna miss the community aspect of the KPA and just the brotherhood and just the fun times that you can't plan. Have, you just have, we're just amazing people, just coming together and having fun. I think the best thing about the KPA is it's so many different people, and not really people who have a lot in common, but you just appreciate everybody for just who they are, and that's, I think that's just the beauty about the KPA, is everyone's so different, and everyone brings something different to the table, and so you really get to love and appreciate people for who they are, and not just them fitting into the mold of anything, and so that's what makes the KPA just just a bunch of hooligans, you know, just running around, and just people's heart for Jesus is just awesome, and just, yeah, it's what I'm going to miss about the KPA the most.
I told you to take the wizard staff!
I'm just gonna go eat.
The end! You go home now!
There was a time I was out in the woods and I was kind of looking out and I saw a bear and first I was startled, you know, it's a bear in the woods. And then I stopped. I looked at the bear, and the bear turned and looked at me, and I'm like, whoa, what should I be doing right now? But there was this moment that the bear and I had that, yeah, I wouldn't trade that for the world. What was the question?
Hi everybody, Ryan here. I thought that I would add my small piece to this video. I just wanted to say I made this because I really enjoyed the year here and getting to know everybody, and it was just a really great experience, and I enjoyed all of it. So I thought I'd make this video because I noticed pretty early on that I had a lot of cool footage that I was just taking on my iPhone, so I thought I'd put it into a video. So I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, you guys are great. Thanks for making an awesome year.